may be extending your child's Christmas holiday to try to stop the spread of COVID-19. What say you on this? Let's bring in our political specialist, Cynthia Mulligan, who has been following this. Oh, Sin, where do we begin with this? There are two sides to the story, that's for sure.
That is for sure, Mel, but the one thing I can tell you for sure is it just adds more uncertainty to parents. You have a child in school. Now you're going to have to think, well, what do I do for childcare? Do I have to plan on something either before or after Christmas? The education minister wouldn't say if maybe schools would close sooner, but he did say they are seriously talking to the chief medical officer of health about extending the school year in case people are out socializing during the holidays. So when they come back to school, maybe they wait another week or two so that they limit the possibility of spread, or maybe they don't do in-class learning but they only do online learning. Take a listen to what he had to say.
The bottom line is just protecting the next semester. We've done a lot of good in the first, and I think the announcement we'll unveil will be comprehensive and include a variety of elements, one of which can include something like an extended closure, an online learning experience.
Now, last week, Mel, the government said that it would not do this or consider this and changing the school calendar. And the premier had some pretty strong words about it, too. Now, he has long maintained keeping schools open is the main priority. Shutting them down is a last resort. He reiterated that yesterday and said, you know, parents, I'm not even going to tell you to prepare for this possibility because it may not even happen. So, who knows what will happen, Mel?
Yeah, let's talk about the numbers here, Sin. How many outbreaks that we're seeing within the public school system, and as well as whether or not it is a source of transmission, our school system.
Well, that is such an interesting question. So we know, the last I checked yesterday morning, because there's that Ontario school tracker that will detail the number of outbreaks, the number of cases, school by school. 14% of Ontario's 4,200 schools have currently outbreaks. So that's 86% do not. So the government is citing that as a major victory. Only one school is currently shut down because of COVID. The medical officers of health insist that the schools are not the source of transmission, that the kids are getting it at home and bringing it into the schools. And once it does get into the schools, that they're able to clamp it down because of all the measures they've put in place. That's not a lot of consolation to a lot of parents out there, but they are saying that schools are still safe and they're calling it a great success story. So, but clearly they're worried about, because we know that the more COVID is in the community, the more it's going to get into schools. So they are clearly worried about what could happen with spread after Christmas. And we know from last week's modeling that the numbers are pretty dire, you know, up to 7,000 cases a day if they don't change course somehow.
Sin, do you think that the premier or the education minister would be up for more of a regionalized approach? Obviously, you know, we saw the report yesterday, certain pockets of neighborhoods are seeing high positivity rates compared to others. Do you think that that's on the table?
So I did ask the premier that a couple of weeks ago. So his riding, for example, Northwest Etobicoke has a very, very high rate. South Etobicoke does not. So he did say that he wanted them to look at that idea. Nothing has come further from that. I asked specialist from the health table if they would consider that more precision surgical, almost neighborhood by neighborhood. And he said there were a lot of problems with that, in that, you know, people don't tend to work and live in the same neighborhood, so you're not necessarily curbing the spread, because a lot of people in these neighborhoods have to get on transit and work somewhere else. So he wasn't sure that that would actually help. So honestly, my answer to that is no. And my concern personally would be that you're further stigmatizing neighborhoods if you do that.
Yeah, definitely fair there. All right, Cynthia, as always, we appreciate your time and your input on this. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Mel.
8:15 right now, we're going to bring in Natasha. Not